Carcinoid refers to a specific type of tumour, a carcinoid tumour, which causes neuroendocrine cells to secrete hormones. And this leads to all sorts of symptoms, like diarrhea, shortness of breath, and flushing. So when these symptoms develop as a result of a carcinoid tumour, it's called carcinoid syndrome. So what is a neuroendocrine cell? Well, they're found in tissues throughout the body, and particularly in the epithelial layer of the gastrointestinal organs and the lungs. What happens is they receive signals from nerve cells, and in response, they release hormones into the blood. Neuroendocrine cells release a variety of hormones, and these include amines, like serotonin and histamine, as well as polypeptides, like bradykinin, which is a vasodilator, and prostaglandins, which are also very powerful vasodilators. The production of these hormones can be regulated by other hormones. So, for example, somatostatin is a hormone that's made by cells in the hypothalamus, as well as the gastrointestinal tract, and it travels through the blood and binds to the receptors on the surface of neuroendocrine cells. Binding of somatostatin then inhibits the release of a number of hormones from neuroendocrine cells, including serotonin. Now, when serotonin does get released from neuroendocrine cells, it enters the liver through the portal vein. Once in the liver, some of the serotonin is metabolized into 5-hydroxyindoleacetic acid, and that's then eliminated from the body through the urine. But the remaining serotonin is not metabolized, and this portion remains in the systemic circulation, where it has various effects. So let's have a quick look at what this serotonin is getting up to. Well, in the gastrointestinal tract, serotonin increases motility and peristalsis. In the vasculature, platelets take up the serotonin and later use it to constrict blood vessels, particularly after injury. And in the connective tissue of the heart, it stimulates fibroblasts, and these make lots of collagen. Okay, so we get what serotonin does, but where does the tumour side of things come into it? Well, a cell can become cancerous when DNA mutations cause abnormal cellular functions, like uncontrolled, unregulated cellular divisions, which forms a tumour. The limitless replication means that the developing tumour can invade nearby tissue and spread through the blood and the lymph to distant sites in the body, and this is called metastasis. Now, if a neuroendocrine cell mutates and transforms into a cancerous cell, then that cell can continue dividing until it becomes a little mass, and this is a carcinoid tumour. And most of the time, these carcinoid tumours develop in the gastrointestinal tract. Some of the abnormal functions of these cancerous neuroendocrine cells include producing and secreting large amounts of hormones, and, weirdly enough, they also express more somatostatin receptors on their surface, particularly in the gastrointestinal tract, but it's not really known why that happens. Carcinoid tumours tend to be slow-growing, although some can metastasise, often depending on the location. The most common primary sites for carcinoid tumours are someplace along the small or large intestines, as well as the stomach, pancreas, and liver. Also, the lungs and the ovaries in females, and the thymus. Whereas, the most common site for a neuroendocrine tumour to metastasise to is the liver. So the liver can really be a primary or a secondary site of the disease. And it turns out that metastasis, especially to the liver, is actually often necessary for carcinoid syndrome to occur. And that's because these metastases can lead to liver dysfunction, and this decreases the liver's ability to metabolise the hormones which get released from the neuroendocrine cells. And so they build up, and that can cause symptoms. When we get increased histamine and bradykinin, this can cause vasodilation, which leads to flushing, while histamine can also cause itching. Increased serotonin can cause thickening of the collagen and fibrosis, particularly in the heart valves, which can lead to heart dysfunction, like tricuspid regurgitation and pulmonary stenosis. In the airways, it can cause bronchoconstriction, and this leads to asthma, shortness of breath, and wheezing. The increased synthesis of serotonin also reduces the amount of tryptophan available to the body, which is used to make niacin, or vitamin B3. And reduced levels of niacin can cause pellagra, which is a disease which causes symptoms like inflamed skin and mental confusion. So there's a whole load of excess hormones circulating in the blood, and these lead to a bunch of symptoms. And the most common symptoms of carcinoid syndrome include diarrhea, shortness of breath, flushing, and itching. These symptoms can be worsened by alcohol or emotional stress, since these can further stimulate the neuroendocrine cells. Now, diagnosis of carcinoid syndrome can be made through medical imaging, like a CT scan. Also, something called an octreo scan can help identify carcinoid tumours. And what they do is they inject a radio-labelled somatostatin analogue called octreotide, and this binds to the increased number of somatostatin receptors on tumour cells. There's also urinalysis, which shows increased levels of 5-hydroxyindoleacetic acid, while blood tests can show niacin deficiency. When it comes to treatment of carcinoid syndrome, the main aim is to stop hormone production from the neuroendocrine cells. And this can be done with a somatostatin analogue, because these then bind to the somatostatin receptors, and this inhibits the release of hormones. It's also useful to try and decrease emotional stress and alcohol consumption, because this can help limit hormone release. Treatment of the carcinoid tumour itself with surgical resection or chemotherapy can also help to alleviate carcinoid syndrome. So, to quickly go over the main points that we've talked about, carcinoid syndrome, as the word syndrome implies, is a set of symptoms, and these occur as a result of the overproduction of serotonin, histamine, and bradykinin, and this is by neuroendocrine cells, which develop into a carcinoid tumour. The classic symptoms include diarrhea, shortness of breath, flushing, and itching. Diagnosis can be made with an octreotide scan, as well as elevated 5-hydroxyindoleacetic acid in the urine and decreased niacin levels in the blood. Hi everyone, Sarah here. Thanks for watching that video on carcinoid syndrome. I absolutely loved making that. It was fascinating, but equally devastating. But how cool is it that they can treat it with somatostatin analogues? That's amazing. I love that kind of thing. So I hope you enjoyed the video. The script was written by Amanda. It was edited by Rishi and Ifan. And then I did the illustration and the voiceover. And then the whole video was edited by Sam. So thanks everybody for making the video happen. If you like the videos you see on our YouTube channel, then have you headed over to osmosis.org? Because if you haven't, then you should. There are tons more videos on our website that aren't available on our YouTube channel, so that's super helpful. And there are other things like questions, flashcards, and basically like everything you need for med school. And we also do textbooks now as well, so Osmosis is basically your one-stop shop for med school. So, do that, and I look forward to making the next video for you. Bye!